into uncharted territories. We should do it boldly, taking each day that is given to us and making the most out of it. Don't put off tomorrow what you can do today. It's time for the children of God to quit saying, "I'm going to see old brother so-and-so tomorrow," because he may be dead tomorrow. Do it today. Get your life and your calling assured of God. Allow people to know, "I'm on my job. I'm doing what God has called me to do. I got a clean slate. There's nothing on me. He's erased every one of my sins, my bad spells, my things that hold me down. They're gone. Now I'm going to serve God in the beauty of all that I can." Sometimes we get focused on the shouldn't and the wouldest and the couldest, and we don't see the things that are right before us that God wants us to do. I should have read my Bible more. I should have prayed more. I should have tried harder. I'm too busy doing other things that's controlling my life. Other things won't get you to heaven. You better put everything behind you you can. You better center yourself and look toward the cross of Calvary. And if there's anything in your life, you better put it behind you. And you better uplift the bloodstained banner of the Lord Jesus Christ and let this world know. I don't know about everybody else, but me and my family, we're going to serve the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Do all we can. You know, when a person starts getting lukewarm, they don't have to hold a sign up and say, "I'm lukewarm." Just watch them.
Amen. Yeah.
They'll show you.
Amen.
Do you know the Bible said happy is God's people? I don't know why some people look so sad. They don't want to smile. Turn to your neighbor and smile. Oh, man, that was a mistake. Just go ahead and look the way you used to look. Are you happy tonight? Let me tell you something. If you're not happy, you're not where God wants you to be. The Bible said when we get in the center, Brother Taylor, of God's way, we're happy people. We're people that are going to lift up our voices. Yeah, there's things that goes on in our life, and there's things we stumble on, and there's things that we almost hit the ground for. But there's one thing about it. That resurrected power of the Lord Jesus Christ will bring you right back up again, and it'll cause you to be better than you've ever been before. If you've got anything to praise God about, it ought to be that you've got a clean slate. He's washed your sins away, and you wrote your name in the Lamb of Life. My God, you ought to be happy about that today. Somebody raise your hand and praise the Almighty God. Some people say, "Well, I wouldn't have done that. I would have let it happen that way. If I could have tried harder, if I could have been a better example." Do you know every teacher in this church is an example?
Amen.
Whether it be children's church, whether it be the teenagers, whether it be the Sunday school teachers, whether it be the superintendent, the sister superintendent, the Bible teacher, or the clerk, or the pastor. We are examples. Praise God, somebody's watching your life. Somebody said they go to the Donald's Church of God. They are an example. What are you saying, preacher? We need to get the wouldest and the coulders and the shoulders out of our life and do what God has called us to do. You are. Sure, we have memories. We have regrets. But we can't keep thinking about what we didn't do. We've got to do what we know to do. Then we must move forward and make the most out of every day. Every day that you live is a day gone that you won't ever get back again. Do you hear me? Every day that you live, today is gone, except for tonight. Brother Charles, I can't get it back. If God wanted me to do something, it's over. I can't do it now. The day is gone. My Lord, He's been good to us. Let's start out with a clean slate. Let's look toward the man that made it all possible. His name is Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. He's not the little baby that was born on that day. He's not coming back as a little chubby pink little boy coming down of some parade. But He's coming back as King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He is coming in this very time that we're living in today. Somebody first worship God.
Child of the most high God. We go through
New Year's expecting God to be a living guide in us and helping us through each day and through each week. Because we don't know what's in store for us. I think a lot of what we encounter can be good, bad, depending on how we look at it. You see, everything that happens in your life is not bad. Sometimes God allows things to happen to you to make you strong. To make you strong. How many feel like He's done that for you? Hallelujah. He lets things happen to you. Oh my God, and when you see somebody else going through the same thing, when you see somebody else struggling and you see them going through something, some of you have run these aisles and you've shouted and you've praised God and you've speaking in tongues and you've done everything, but you haven't done it lately. Wonder why God didn't move. God hasn't changed. What's wrong with us? It's time for us to get back to Calvary, to get back where God intended us to be. He wiped the slate clean. What's causing us not to worship Him and lift up His holy name? Amen. Amen. These things. What's in store for you? Is it good? Is it bad? You have to go to a palm reader to find that out. I'm not wanting to do that. But I will tell you this. God is a gracious, loving God. Too often when life isn't going our way, we let Satan get into our heads. And we start acting like we're defeated before it ever starts. It seems that we forgot about all the things that God works for the good of those that love Him. Who've been called according to His purpose. For those God's foreknew, He also predestinated to conform to His image of God, and that we might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And we look around and we say, Lord, why are You like this happened to me? But then you need to look around and look and say, hey, the slate's clean. What did they do with Job? He lost everything he had. Some of us lose is one thing and we go to the doctor and get nerve pills. But he lost everything he had. He had nothing, Brother Taylor, on the slate. He lost his home. He lost all his livestock. He lost his family. Sitting around a campfire, his three best friends said, Job, surely you done something against God. Don't think he hadn't come to me and said, hey, surely you've done something for your wife to be sick like she is. That's not the reason, folks. Job said, his wife said, curse God and die. But Job said, you talk like a foolish woman. Amen. Glory. Right. I ain't about to cuss God and die. I'm going to lift up my hands and praise Him. Because one of these days, and one of these days soon, she's going to be healed by the glory of God. And all those devils are going to be able to stand back and see that the power of God had a time and a place. And He's going to get the glory. Her slate clean. You know, when you look up there and you see that the Lord was in that Travis, and you see the slate clean, think about your life. your slate clean by Jesus. No preacher, no priest, no sun, young moon, nobody but the blood. But the blood, it took the blood to wipe your slate clean. And if yours is clean, why don't you throw your hands in the air and glorify God and say, Lord, I just want to thank you for having a clean slate. What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What? Help me. Somebody knows it. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Do you try to get away from it, you will die in your transgressions. But if you will hold on to the unchanging God, if you will hold on to the unchanging hand of God, you're going to be washed. Somebody say washed. Washed.
Jesus were to come, I would
wouldn't make it. All my life, my one ambition is to be, when this life is over, that I'm going to be with the Lord. That's what I want. I got loved ones that's there. I got friends that are there. I've got people that I've preached their funerals from every church that I've ever pastored. They're there. And I want to see them. If there's anything on your slate, you need to get it off tonight. In the name of Jesus. I'm going to wait just a minute. You can walk out that door. You say no to God. Maybe what you want to do is more important. But when you lay down to die, it won't be more important. Anybody want to pray? In the name of Jesus. Anybody want to pray? It's up to you.
We thank you, Lord God, for the service. We thank you for the worship, Lord God, for everything was done to serve tonight and accomplish in the lives and the hearts of your people, Father. Lord God, we ask for strength to guide us through the remaining part of this week. We ask that you guide and direct our hearts and our spirits. In Jesus Christ's precious name, amen.